doing what they're doing. Come on, you ready?
Yeah, 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 man. I'm Andy Emilio with ES News. Got Lil B-hop here, man. I heard that nickname, man. Explain that to me. Where does that come from? Is that your fighting style? What is it?
Yeah, they said, because when I first started, they said I used to fight like B-hop. Because, the you know, the style, like the charisma in the ring, character, the tongue sticking out and all that.
So was that one of your big inspirations to get into fighting? Is that somebody you watched and studied?
Before, it was Mayweather. Still is Mayweather, but now that's one of my biggest inspirations in life.
So is Mayweather your favorite fighter?
B-hop and Mayweather?
So what made you acquire that style? You're from Brooklyn, right?
Yeah.
All right. So that's type of Philly style. So what made you pick up on that style and maybe not a fighter like Zab Judah or something?
I mean, I don't know. That was just me. When I first started.
So they gave you the nickname and then you started to look more at B-hop, or you already had an interest in B-hop?
I started looking at B-hop like 3 years ago.
All right.
And I've been boxing for like 4 or 5 years.
And how old are you now?
18.
So what do you see, or what are you hoping to make happen in your pro debut?
A victory. That's it.
Any special kind of it? A knockout, TKO?
If it come, it come. I mean, I'm not going to go in there looking for it. So I was never known like of the biggest puncher, but my speed, I got a lot of speed, so I'm going there and use it to try to get the victory. Not try, but I'm going there and get the victory.
For the people who might not know, what's your amateur career like?
I was a 4-time national champion, Golden Glove national champion, Ringside World Champion. I was ranked number 1 in the country.
All right.
Before I left the amateurs.
So, being that you're going to be fighting on this card, right?
Yeah.
So, how big is that for you to be fighting in your hometown?
I mean, it's very big, because a lot of people don't get the opportunity to fight in their hometown on a pro debut. Barely, never. They don't never get the opportunity to fight in their hometown on such a big card on a pro debut.
How are you dealing with the media, and you're gonna get that taste of fame right now? How does it feel transitioning to that?
It's regular for me. I've always had the media following me. I always had a lot of fans from the amateurs, because I was always known in the boxing game, in the pro boxing game, since I was young.
Now, I just heard over there when you were on stage, you had a whole crowd there screaming your name and a bunch of people shouting you out. How does that feel to know you got a big name to live up to with that nickname, B-Hop? That's a legend right there. So to be like Little B-Hop, you got to live up to that name, B-Hop.
It felt great, but I know what a lot of people expect from me, and I'm going to prove them what they expect from me is right. It's just not talk, it's real life.
So being that you're such a young guy yourself, who were your favorite fighters when you were growing up?
Mayweather? Adrian Broner.
And how about, do you have any fighters from New York that you were looking up to?
Zab Judah, Marcus Brown.
All right. Professor Marcus?
Yeah, that's my pick.
All right.
Curtis Stevens and Danny Jacobs. Luis Collazo.
All right, yeah, those are good guys right there, man. Let me get a couple predictions. Who do you got in Adrian Broner, Sean Porter?
Adrian Broner?
How do you see that fight going along? You think it's going to go to a decision?
Yeah,
outbox him?
Yeah, outbox him. Make him look foolish.
You got Chris Algieri, Long Island, hometown guy. What do you see with him and Khan?
I see it going to the decision. A lot of people say American will knock him out, but I can't see it. Chris Algieri moved too much. He's fast on the feet.
So you have Algieri winning?
No, I got Khan.
Khan winning?
Algieri's going to give him a great fight.
All right.
I mean, it could go either way. You never know. Because Khan know how to box. Algieri know how to box. He's not the guy to stay in there and bang and get hit all crazy. As you can see with Pacquiao, he didn't really get hit that much with Pacquiao. He got dropped, but he didn't get hit that much. But when he got hit, he felt it. And all the shots that out of the 5 drops he got dropped, like 3 of them were slips. He just got caught on the way going down.
So what do you think, what other fights are you talking about?
Kovalev versus Mohammadi.
Yeah.
Kovalev.
What fights do you want to see? Like a Triple G, Kid Chocolate, the Kovalev, Adonis Stevenson. What fantasy fights are you most interested in?
The Keith Thurman fight and Luis Collazo is coming up too.
You got that fight? You got Collazo on that fight?
Yeah.
That's a good one right there.
You got him because of your big bro?
Nah, I got him because I think he can win. He's slick.
Slick, yeah.
Keith Thurman is tight wild. He throw a lot of wide shots. To me, all Colazo got to do is stand in the pocket, stay smooth, make him miss, and just start touching him. He make him look foolish. That's what you got to really do. Keith Thurman is not that much. He's not hard to hit.
Keith Thurman and Amir Khan are both...
Keith Thurman is hard to hit to you?
...in the race for a Floyd Mayweather fight. If they both get these victories, who do you think is more likely?
Keith Thurman cannot fuck with Floyd. That's one. Floyd will beat the shit out of him. We have a field day with Keith Thurman. Amir Khan, it would be a better fight. Because Amir Khan is fast. He don't throw that much wide punches. He throws straight punches. How could you miss when you're throwing a lot of straight punches?
A lot of people are throwing the name Ty Triple G in there with Floyd. Would you want to see that fight, or is he too big for him?
That's too big for me. To me, I think that's too big for Floyd. But if Floyd was to go up, he still would beat Triple G. It's not hard to beat Triple G. They just don't put the right person in front of him yet. They haven't put the right person in
front. Who would you like to see Triple G in there with that you think is the right person? All right.
Demetrius Andrade. All
right.
People like that. Danny Jacobs, Kachuk.
Sounds good.
I didn't say he could win. I didn't say Danny Jacobs didn't.
From New York, Danny Jacobs from New York. A little bias, a little bit.
Not even a little.
Even cooler. He was at that's another New York. Even though he mentioned Michigan, but he claiming New York too. He's a little bias.
Michigan. but I think he'll get
claiming New York.
I think he'll get Kachuk. I mean, Golovkin to fight because he got power and he can keep it. You know how to keep his distance. You don't think so?
I don't know, man. Pizzato, he had them Bambi eyes, man. It was like wide open, and Pizzato don't got no power, so I just can't see nobody being Golovkin. Not right now, not at 160.
That's just crazy.
At 160? Come on, man. Ooh, at 160.
Okay, you can't
at
do this
160.
For long, bro.
All right, so give me a name. Give me a name.
You can't do this for long, bro.
What about a guy like Andy Lee?
Nah.
Fuck no.
Andy Lee got knocked out by Brian Vera.
What about Demetrius Andrade?
He's 154.
He's not going to move. I spoke to Demetrius Andrade. He said he's not moving up to 160 to fight Triple G.
But if he was to fight Triple G, how you would see that going?
He's going to have to come up. We got to see.
Look,
it all matter. It all comes down to the power. Like, if you can't hurt Golovkin, how do you stop him from hitting you?
Nah, but when you got constant punches coming to your head and constant punches touching you.
All right, Willie Monroe was doing that.
Nah, he wasn't doing it enough.
Shit.
Willie Monroe was
not. He was hitting Golovkin with like 3-punch combinations.
So Willie Monroe is better than.
I'm not saying he's better than nobody.
He can't beat Demetrius Andrade.
I'm saying he did what you asked him people to do. The only difference could beat is going to be that power,
He could beat a lot.
One of my favorite fighters out there,
man. I think he could beat Canelo.
And
he's the only guy I fear to fight Floyd.
Who he knocked out at 154?
Who?
Demetrius. He knocked nobody. Greatest brawl. This was like 5 years ago, bro. I'm not saying he can't fight, but if you can't stop Golovkin from coming at you, how do you win?
You could be faster than him and outpoint him.
You gotta have.
What about Willie? Willie was faster.
You gotta have.